When Riverdale was first announced, a lot of people had some very understandable skepticism about what the show was going to be like in terms of story and content. Not the least of which is that they were taking the beloved Archie characters, making them more modern, which the comics had honestly done to great success, and then putting them in the style of CW teen dramas that the network has been a bit famous for. And sure enough, while the show has lasted much longer than anyone expected, there are some awkward and downright cringe moments that have happened on and off camera. Allow us to show you Riverdale Most Awkward Moments. I'm a weirdo. In case you haven't noticed, Jughead is weird. He's a weirdo. He doesn't fit in, nor does he want to fit in. Have you ever seen him without his stupid hat? All jokes aside, it's definitely clear to everyone from the very beginning of the show that Jughead, Cole Sprouse, is an oddball with a sarcastic sense of humor. Still, his famous monologue from the first season, in which he tries to highlight his individuality instead of being dramatic, sounded like it came out straight from the room. Given that probably no one took it seriously, Jughead's famous speech eventually attained meme status, and deservedly so, if we may add.
In case you haven't noticed, I'm weird. I'm a weirdo.
Granted, Jughead and Sprouse got better as the show went on, which is typical in most TV shows, but this one definitely sticks out as awkward in both delivery and it being allowed to be put into the final cut. The maiming of KJ Apa. Without a doubt, the core of Riverdale is in its main characters, and the biggest of the bunch is obviously Archie, who in this show is played by KJ Apa. But if you were to look at him before Riverdale and then look at him during the series, you're going to have a bit of a double take as his hair went from brunette to redhead. This was obviously intentional because in the legendary Archie comics, he's a redhead, and to change from that would be a major departure from a beloved character, which obviously you could say about the entirety of Riverdale, but we digress. Anyway, before filming happened, they had to bleach not just his hair, but his eyebrows as well, in order to nail the look. The problem, though, was that in the process of doing that, they severely burned AJ, to the point where he had burns all over his face in spots and could have easily damaged his eyes if a few things didn't go his way. It took him another week to get better before he felt comfortable enough to be back on set. That just goes to show you that even in simple teen dramas, there are a lot of things that could go wrong. Dark Betty. At first glance, Betty Cooper, played by Lily Reinhart, is your typical blonde girl next door. But she also has a dark side, a character fans have come to know as Dark Betty. This alter ego is often characterized by a black wig and lacy underwear, transforming the usual do-good star pupil into a sexpot and webcam model. Seriously? And while this dark side of hers represents a vent from some deep psychological issues Betty is dealing with, instead of taking a more serious approach, the show makes it incredibly cringy and played out by having her dress up what she thinks is a stereotypical bad girl. Just one of the many things that the show has done to show off its dark tone. And yeah, it was a bit much. In fact, a lot of things from season one was a bit much, but it apparently worked as the show kept going. The maiming of KJ Apa, part two. Oh, you thought the hair drama was the only thing that KJ Apa had to deal with on the set of the series? Nope, it gets worse. Don't get us wrong, getting burned on your face is pretty bad and something no one should have to deal with. But no, his maiming didn't end there. In a key scene, Archie is attempting a rescue and is punching the ice with his hand. He didn't fake this though, and literally tried to punch through ice for the scene, despite him actually punching a mat. The problem was that he almost broke his hand doing this. KJ admitted that he got into character too much, and the mat got so cold that it was like punching something rather solid and thus basically broke his hand. Ouch. Granted, part of it was his fault as he went a bit too all in on the matter. But that doesn't mean that the crew didn't fail him by setting him up in a situation where he could go and break his hand. Just saying. Veronica and Jughead. Yet another scene that caused discomfort in Riverdale fans occurred in the second season when Betty, Jughead, Archie, and Veronica decided to go on a weekend trip. During their stay at a cabin in the woods, another pop culture cliche, the secret that Betty and Archie kissed leaked, to which Veronica suggested she should kiss Betty's boyfriend, Jughead, to make things even. Not only is this embarrassing story writing for a popular TV show, but the visibly uncomfortable situation was made worse by the fact that Lily, Betty, and Cole, Jughead, were in a relationship off the set as well. In any case, given we've also already witnessed a kiss between Betty and Veronica, we guess the only thing left is a kiss between Archie and Jughead, which isn't so unlikely given how the show has developed over the years. Though, we're sure some of you would like that, right? The near death of KJ Apa. Yeah, this kid just can't catch a break, as you can tell. It was bad enough that the show burned his face and that he broke his hand. But a lapse in judgment on the show crew's part almost led to the death of KJ himself. Here's the story. It was after a long day of filming, and KJ noted that he was going to go home. The problem, though, was that he was tired, and everyone could see that, but they let him drive home. The second problem, if you will, was that he wasn't just driving home, he was driving from the set to his home, which was hours away, and it was nighttime. As a result of this, KJ fell asleep while on the highway, and his car crashed heavily into a light pole. Police and medics were called, and he was rushed to the hospital, and thankfully he was all right. But that was no doubt an experience he never wants to experience again. The irony of the situation is that Cole Sprouse was supposed to be riding with him, but that changed at the last moment. So, if things had gone wrong instead of lucky, Riverdale would be out of its two biggest stars. Since the incident, the set is much safer, and anytime a cast member notes that they're tired before leaving, they're provided with a driver. Given recent events in Hollywood, see Alec Baldwin, you can bet that all the CW shows are going to work overtime to make sure their sets are as safe as possible. Endgame. The phrase endgame is so overused that its sole usage to describe literally every couple in this show provokes nothing but a big cringe in the audience.
Because we're endgame, Archie.
In one of the very first episodes, Kevin told Betty that she and Archie were endgame. Or, actually, to clarify, Betty and Archie aren't dating, but they're endgame. At least according to Kevin. Hearing the characters constantly call their relationships endgame has gotten way too stale, way too fast, to the point where, in most fans, it provokes an eye roll every time it happens. A small gripe? Yeah, sure. But bad writing needs to be called out. Polly and Jason. The weird incestuous vibes between the Blossom twins could be sensed from the very beginning of the show. Later, the tables have turned when it was revealed that Jason Blossom, Trevor Steins, and Polly Cooper, Tira Scoveby, who were the ones in an incestuous relationship. Although their love affair ended abruptly, and unfortunately with Jason's murder, the icing on the cake was the discovery that Polly and Jason were actually cousins. On top of that, following the even Polly had Jason's twins, which brings us to the part that never ceases to make us cringe. She named them Juniper and Dagwood. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at Riverdale and some of the awkward moments that happened in the show and on set? Can you believe that all these things happened or were allowed to happen? Which of these moments do you hear about and cringe or remember how awkward it was when it first aired? Let us know in the comments below and we'll see you next time on the channel.